Oof. I know you guys think I put all this work into all these videos, but I've gotten in such a bad habit lately of filming the day before I post them, and it's been some early mornings. I'm Justin, your fellow procrastinator, and this channel is all about virtual reality development, plus games, tech demos, and all things virtual reality. Let's talk about some UI.
Oh,
and this tutorial doesn't have any coding. First, we're going to be going through and setting up all the, you know, XR settings and making sure everything's right. So if you already know how to do that, or if you've seen one of my other videos, skip to that timestamp right there, and that will start the UI part of it. We're in a new URP project, starting completely from scratch this time. And if you'll notice, I'm using Unity 2020.3.2, just upgraded to that version, but this project should work in 2019.3 or newer. So as long as you have it above that version, you should be fine. First, we're gonna go to Edit, Project Settings, and then Package Manager, and check the Enable Preview Packages box. I understand. Now let's go to Window, Package Manager, and we want to swap this over to Unity Registry, and then look for OpenXR plugin, install that. It's going to ask you to restart because it's going to set you to the new input system, so just hit yes, the project will restart. And let's open up the Package Manager again and scroll down to the very bottom, XR Interaction Toolkit. We're gonna install that, as well as the samples default input actions. Now we're back here in the project settings. Let's go down here to XR Plugin Management and check the OpenXR box, and then go down here to Features and check Oculus Touch Controller Profile or whatever headset you're using. Go back into XR Plugin Management, click on this exclamation point, and then click Fix All. There we go. If you have an Oculus Quest, you'll need to go to File, Build Settings, and swap over to Android. You'll need to install the Android portion of Unity Hub and then switch platforms in order to run your project on an Oculus Quest or a standalone device. Otherwise, we're sticking with the PC, Mac, and Linux standalone. A few more steps. Let's go down to the Project pane, go to Samples, XR Interaction Toolkit, whatever version you're using, and default input actions, and then we're just going to go through and add all of these presets. And then after we do that, we're going to go back to the Edit Project Settings, and then to the Preset Manager. And then inside of here, find the Action-Based Controller preset, and we're going to label these right and left accordingly. Now we can add an XR rig to our project. So right-click in the hierarchy, go to XR and Room Scale XR rig action based. Inside of that XR rig, we want to add a component, and this component's going to be the input action manager. And then we want to drag the XRI default into the action assets. And now we should be all set up. If you went into this right now, you should have two lines coming out of your hands that you can move around. All right, let's start making a canvas. So I'm going to reposition my XR rig and face it towards the wall because we're going to project, or we're going to put the canvas on this wall here, and let's scale these icons down. Much better. So this is going to start out just like adding any other canvas. You right click in the hierarchy, go to UI, and then you add a canvas. This is going to come with an event system, so we're just going to throw this to the top with our XR interaction manager. We're going to update this in a minute, but let's talk about canvas first. So normally you have this screen space overlay. That's the render mode that it's in. So if we double click on the canvas, we can zoom out and see this is a giant canvas. And then if you can barely tell, there's a green dot down here in the corner, and that's where our little world is. And the canvas is huge. And if we were to run this, the canvas, you wouldn't even see it if you were in VR. Nothing would happen. And you've got two other options here for render mode. There is screen space camera. This would let your player actually see the canvas, but it's gonna be stuck to the camera. So wherever that person looked, it would follow. And so that's not really what we want. So we're going to go down and select world space here at the bottom. World space is going to require an event camera. So let's drag our main camera into that spot. And then let's scale this way down. There we go. And I'm going to mount it to this wall right here. And when you're adjusting the scale, make sure your X and your Y are the same values, because if they end up being different, your text and buttons and stuff, they're going to look stretched one way or the other. So try to keep your X and Y the same. And if you need to adjust the height or the width, you can do it with these values here. And now we can go ahead and add text and buttons to this like you would a normal UI. So let's add a little text box here, and I'm gonna scale up the width and the height. And our text is facing the wrong way, so let's grab the canvas and just flip it around. And with the font, you'll want to scale it with the font size, not the scale. If you scale it up with just scale, it's gonna start to look blurry the bigger it gets. So font size is how you wanna make font bigger. And this is gonna be a wet paint sign. And let's add a button and a slider just to demonstrate. And these are gonna obviously behave just like any other button or slider. You're gonna have this on click event for the button that you can put any method into that you want to execute when the button's clicked. And then the same thing, you have an on value changed for the slider. So whenever that gets moved back or forth, it's going to update that value and run whatever method you want it to run. But how do you interact with these? Right now, if you just played it, you would not be able to interact with the buttons or sliders or anything. So let's fix that. Inside of the canvas, we're gonna wanna add a new component. This one's gonna be called the Tracked Device Graphic Raycaster. We don't need to do anything in here, we just need to add this component. And then in the event system, let's go up in here and delete this standalone input module, and then we're going to add an XR UI input module. And this will allow the raycast from the left hand and the right hand controllers to interact with this button and slider. So I'm gonna select both of these, and we're going to mask nothing and then switch it to UI. Now the raycast will only turn the activated color if it's touching UI, and we're gonna have the invalid color gradient be 0 alpha. In this way, the raycast will only show up if you're pointing directly at the button or the slider or the text. Also, I'm gonna adjust this down a little bit so it's a little thinner, because I think that looks so much better. So let's jump in and test this and make sure it works. All right, let's wait for everything to render. And now you'll see the pointers only show up if I'm hovering over a UI element, and if I point away, then the pointers disappear, which is exactly what we want. So I could just drag the slider back and forth, and click on the button, all of that works nicely. And that's basically it. That's the whole tutorial. Now you can do some pretty cool things with this in VR by just parenting the canvas onto physical objects. So if we wanted to create a tablet, let's actually do that real quick. Let's create a new empty object. We're going to call this tablet. And then inside of that, we're going to create a 3D cube object. Make sure both of these transforms are set to 0. I'm going to move the tablet up to where I want it. And then let's reset the cube scale to like 0.02, 0.01. And then the Y is going to be 0.5, no, 0.2. And let's put the Z at 0.4. Yeah, that looks good. A little bit big for a tablet, but you know. And then let's grab the canvas. I'm just gonna duplicate it and drop it into the tablet. Set the positions down to 0 again. Pull it out a little bit. And then we wanna scale it down even more. There we go. I'm gonna change the text to tablet. And then let's make this tablet an XR grab interactable. Let's have it, yeah, it can use gravity, sure, whatever. And then the left hand and right hand, go back to the ray interactor, and let's also create a new layer called grabbable, and we're gonna put the tablet in this grabbable layer. Grabbable, let's set the raycast mask to also include grabbable, and then let's set the tablet layer to grabbable. And yes, the children can change. Now if we play, I can select the tablet, pick it up, and then also interact with it. You can do so much stuff with this. You can add a bullet counter to guns. You can do a ton of different UI things with this, from heads up displays to tablets like I just showed you, to a weapon bullet counter, to, you know, anything you can think of, really. You can also take some elements from the last video about buttons and put the physicalized buttons onto the tablet too if you wanted to, and instead of using a UI like this, you could do a physicalized UI, which is usually and arguably better for VR, and just put those on the tablet. And instead of having the buttons look like, you know, they're actual like big toy buttons, you could turn the mesh into more of like a hologram looking one, and then you can press the button and it's still physicalized, but it looks like you're interacting with a digital interface. There you have it. There's a super basic UI setup, and I hope you guys can take some of those ideas and just run with them and make some really cool UI stuff. I am not a designer by any means, and I'm sure some of you can come up with some super cool UI, like holographic looking elements and whatnot. But, you know, there's my stone tablet and a little slider on it, and you guys can take the rest and run with it. Add a button to your wrist that will activate the UI and have it pop up, like a little watch or something like that. You could have, you know, tablets, phones, lots of cool stuff there. And I'm excited to see what you guys come up with. And holy cow, we just hit 1,000 subscribers. That's absolutely incredible. Y'all's support and encouragement has been absolutely amazing. And thank you to my VIP Patreons, Ken, Reha, Austin, Tim, Scott, Jane, and Ava. Thank you guys all so much for continuing to support me. And if you're watching this video and you want to support me, or if you just want access to the source code, you can support me on Patreon and grab that. And of course, free of charge, as always, I comment and reply to every single one of the comments underneath one of my videos. So if you ever run into any issues or need some help troubleshooting, just put a comment down there and I will reply as soon as I can. Thank you all so much, and I'll see you in the next video.